I'm Barry Laminack, and this isn't what happened in sports. Let's start with some NFL, where the Houston Texans continue to socially distance themselves from the win column and are now 0-3 after losing to the Pittsburgh Steelers on Sunday. Man, head coach Bill O'Brien is going to get an earful from general manager Bill O'Brien. During a press conference this week, Patriots coach Bill Belichick wore a sweatshirt covered in holes from what I assumed was when he was shot by the fashion police. He looks like who the ghost of Christmas future warns you about. Is he trying to score touchdowns or heroin? Well, at least that explains his holier-than-thou attitude though, right? Tyrod Taylor missed a second week of games after the Chargers team doctor reportedly poked a hole in Taylor's lung while giving him an injection before last week's game. Questions began to surface about the doctor's credentials, but were soon squashed after it was discovered he went to the school of the University of Hasbro. Don't touch the sides. Joe Montana saved his grandchild from kidnapping when a woman tried to abduct the baby from his home. Montana ripped the baby from the would-be kidnapper's arms and then spiked it in celebration because old habits die hard. The New York Jets not only lost to the Indianapolis Colts this week, but they also set a record as the only team in the league to have never led at any point in any game. Jets fans are so pissed they're now organizing a protest to get head coach Adam Gase fired. That way they can hire someone else to lose 10 games a year. From the world of the NBA, the Los Angeles Lakers are set to take on the Miami Heat in the NBA Finals this year. The Lakers and LeBron James are heavy favorites to win yet another NBA title. This will be James's 10th NBA championship finals with his third team. That's three cities. Only drag queens have brought more pride to more cities across this country. James has made more finals appearances than the student taking exams for Lori Loughlin's daughter. An Instagram model claims an NBA player paid her $7,000 and brought her inside the Disney bubble. And damn, Disney rides are getting expensive. Doc Rivers has parted way with the Los Angeles Clippers after another early exit in the playoffs, and when asked to comment on it, Kawhi Leonard said, "Darn." Paul George was scheduled for comments, but he refused to show up, so looks like he's still in playoff mode. In other sports news, the Astros have reached the postseason with a losing record, and this is the proof that you needed that they didn't need to cheat to win, because they didn't win, and they still cheated the system. The team made the playoffs despite having multiple injuries to many key players, including George Springer, Jose Altuve, Lance McCullers, Alex Bregman, this guy. Reggie Bush was caught on camera falling asleep on the set of the Fox College football show. I guess Reggie was bushed. I hate me too. All right, and finally, in Oxford, Mississippi, fans booed when Florida and Ole Miss took a knee for a moment of unity. And I'm not sure if they were booing the kneeling or the fact that they live in Mississippi. It looks like Ole Miss started their 2020 season in 1958. I'm Barry Laminack. That's not what happened in sports.